Hello and welcome to my channel. This is Jan Tislat and today we are going to draw together and I will try to speak to you normally, not the way I do. Actually, before I edit my videos, I always write a script and I noticed listening to the videos afterwards that the way I speak sounds so unnatural and so tense that I absolutely hate it. In fact, I hate the way my voice sounds anyhow because I'm transgender and whenever I have to record myself I feel that my dysphoria skyrockets, but I have no means for any hormone therapy and I have a lot of other issues why it's not an option to me right now, and this is why I just have to deal with my voice as it is. And since I wanted to be an art YouTuber and I really want to talk to you guys and I want you to hear my voice and maybe one day see me, because I'm somehow planning to record videos with my head in the screen, on the screen. And also there is also that fact that I don't speak English as good as I want to, and I'm so anxious that my Eastern European accent, which is so often marked in media, will be heard. And so, like, to summarize all of this, I just realized that I am so stiff when I try to record my audios for my videos. So I tried to kind of experiment and to record this without any script, without trying to make it sound perfect, no matter in terms of grammar or what I say or with my accent. So this is an experiment. As well as the painting I'm doing, this is also an experiment, because as you can see, lately I've been mostly painting with digital media, mostly in Procreate and Clip Studio Paint. But to me, traditional materials is something I started with, because that was something I felt more comfortable with in some way, because I kind of felt the paper and felt the materials. So to do this experimental video with me talking without any script, I chose the subject of me drawing painting of a random guy. I really don't know who is this. It's just a photo I saw on Pinterest, and of course if you guys know who the model is, then please let me know. So this is just a random guy. I decided to paint him with gouache, and to me gouache is like art therapy, because it's such a forgiving material and you can just do anything you want with it, and it always is possible to correct any mistake you made, well, almost any, of course, to some point. So this is what I decided to do. I chose a very, very firm craft paper for this, with such a natural skin tone as the base, so kind of I already have my mid-tone with my painting, so I can dance around it. And this is also very interesting. So to me, this sort of an experiment is relaxing, and I hope that it will help me loosen myself a little bit and not think about how I sound or what I say. And for this moment, I guess we're already like halfway through with the beginning of the painting. I already made the sketch and started to paint. When I paint with gouache, to me, I said it's like Photoshop. You can just drop in any colors and they look ugly at first, of course, but then when you start rendering the picture, it gets better and better, and eventually it can go wherever the sort of creamy texture the paint gives you will lead you. And this is what I love gouache for. And it is funny because, you know, in Russia, in art circles, many people think that gouache is sort of a paint that kids paint, you know, like children generally are taught how to paint their first artworks in kindergarten or in art schools with gouache, probably because it is so forgiving as it is, and probably and also cheap. Even though I wouldn't say, I wouldn't call my gouache cheap, it's definitely not, because most brands I use are either Winsor and Newton gouache or Panonnina, I guess this is the name, and this is a Hungarian brand, which is really good. Actually, it's almost as good as Winsor and Newton brand, which is surprising because it's not as famous. But I wouldn't call it cheap. Of course, it's Panonnina is much, much cheaper than Winsor & Newton, but it's also not cheap in terms of the local market prices. And the gouache paints I used when I was a kid, it was really cheap. It was like very cheap, the cheapest my parents could get me. And of course, because this is what we experimented with. And somehow when I paint with gouache, I have this feeling of looseness, because I know that whatever I do, I can correct this and I don't waste too much money. And the paper is also not the most expensive one. So kind of, I feel much more at ease with what I do and I can try something new. And this is what I really encourage you to do, because just find your material if you feel comfortable with and you don't feel like you're wasting it, and just go on and try something new. Oh my god, sometimes, you know guys, I wonder how YouTube art bloggers manage to talk about so many different things while they're filming the videos, because I've been watching a lot of YouTubers, art YouTubers, who talk all the way through their drawings, not like mine, because mine, it approximately took about 3 hours, and this video is three times faster, probably something, maybe not three, maybe even six times faster, yes, I guess six times faster than the original one. And I still feel like I will be struggling eventually, like, what do I talk about, what do I say, is it even relevant to the video, is anybody listening? And I've been watching a lot of videos by other artists who sometimes make huge and really long sketchbook tours, or they really draw in real time for like hours and they don't get tired and they don't run out of subjects to talk about something. And it is interesting, it is relevant, it is actually kind of relaxing to hear them talk. And this is what really bothering me, whether anybody is still there listening to what I say at all, because like I feel like I'm just sitting here and trying to come out with ideas in a foreign language and try to find the words to sound, literate. But it is so hard, and I feel kind of stupid just to comment on what I'm doing, even though maybe probably this is what you're expecting me to do. And at this moment, I'm just adding the cool shades to my painting so they pop out. And because, you know, the skin of the face has different hues, and some of them are warmer and some of them are lighter. And since the background I chose is bright orange, then I take some greenish bluish light paint to highlight the lightest part of the skin. So this is what I'm doing at the moment, aside from trying to talk to you guys about all the things that come up to my head. But so far I guess it's been already 8 minutes and I still didn't give up on this experiment of mine, trying to talk without a script. And I really wonder if I will be able to do this until the end of the video. And by the way, if you're still watching, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, because I'm going to do a lot of cool stuff. Lately I've only had enough time to update my channel weekly. It's each Thursday, so whenever it's Thursday, unless I'm dead, I will post a video with a speed paint or a tutorial, or maybe one day it's going to be a video vlog and you will see me in person. Probably this will happen if I will be brave enough and if you will like this video enough, so it will encourage me to continue. So I'm not hinting on anything, but if you can leave like and comment on what I do, this would be great, because this would show me that this experiment is successful, which is very important to me. And as you can probably feel, I am nervous about what I'm doing, because I don't know what I'm doing, I have no idea what I'm doing, but still I'm going to try and go on. And this is actually what I did when I started to learn how to draw, because this was the way I learned myself. I haven't a single idea of what I was doing, and because I'm self-taught, and I've been always kind of interested in drawing. When I was a kid, I often paused my VCR and tried to copy Disney characters which I liked from the screen. So that was my leisure time, especially when I was at sick leave at home. And I wasn't the healthiest child, so I kind of often stayed at home because of the flu or something. But then, you know, adult life took me in and I didn't draw for kind of pretty long time. And then when me and my husband, we moved from a homophobic Russia to Hungary, which is also kind of homophobic right now, and a transphobic, which is a problem. Probably we're going to move somewhere else, but okay, I'm not going to vent about this. So when we moved here, I somehow felt like I really want a free space for me just to express myself and to de-stress and to decompress. And this is where I started drawing again. And that was the very same thing. Like, I didn't know what I was doing. I didn't know where I was going. I just wanted to paint. And that's how I learned. And it worked. And I hope that probably it will work here as well. Anyhow, I've been doing my channel, like uploading videos regularly for probably just a few months, maybe 3 months or something, and I already have 500 followers. According to my last count, it's 545, which is amazing. I really don't know why you chose me, my dear people, because somehow I really find my videos kind of a beginner level, and not in terms of painting, even though this is also an issue, but like in terms of being watchable and being interesting. To me, they seem to be kind of regular at this moment, but I'm working on it, honestly. And that's kind of funny, because I didn't have a single thought about how to do editing, video editing. This was also a thing I had to teach myself and to experiment with. And at first I tried to do this in DaVinci Resolve, but it simply killed me with its lag and how it simply just stopped working on me at some point. And also, I guess I also tried a few video editors, which I didn't have a single idea how they work. And I tried to use them, and like it didn't lead me to any quality results. So I ended up with Sony Vegas, which I like. I mean, like finally, after a few weeks of messing with it, I understood how it works. And each new video I make feels kind of a little bit easier to make. And as you notice here in my video, since I know that already 500 people are watching me, I'm trying to do my best to impress you guys. So as you can see here, I even made two camera angles for this video. One I filmed from my webcam from above, and the other one with my phone. And I bought a whole new phone with a better camera to make those videos for. So I'm updating my setup, and I'm trying to raise the quality of my videos, if you can put it this way. And as you can see, it really gets better in a way, I hope. And if it does, this is also a chance for you, if you haven't already, to like my video and to tell me in comments if it looks better than the previous ones and if what I say is understandable. So this is what I did. I trying to be an art YouTuber, I really try to raise the quality of my videos and to try new formats. Like this one is when I'm drawing, and the speed paint is not too fast, so you guys can see quite clearly what I'm doing. For example, right now I'm adding some details and some highlights and trying to make some minor corrections with the facial features, just to make them look more like the model I've been using. So you guys can see this, and I'm talking in the background and coming up with weird ideas and subjects to talk about. Even though for me it's kind of easier to talk about art and how it affects my life, and probably this is going to be the main subject of most of my videos. And Gaga, it's interesting that right now it's already been 15 minutes through the video. It's a half, because this video is going to be 30 minutes long. It's a half of the video. And I can feel that I'm starting to loosen up, really. It's much easier for me to talk. It's like, it starts to feel as if English is not as foreign to me as I used to think it is, and that it's easier for me to find the words to express what I'm saying. And I can still hear that I'm producing those weird sounds like and but I guess you guys forgive me for this, because I'm really trying as hard as I can and doing as much as I can. So what should we talk about right now? Right now, you know, watching the video at the moment kind of helps me, because I see what I'm doing and I can try to come up with the idea of what you might be interesting to hear me tell you. For example, let's talk about brushes for the gouache. As you can see, mostly I use the flat synthetic brushes, because they are very good with, like, not allowing me to go too much into the details. And I like those flat strokes. They have a texture and they are very easy to use to sculpt the shapes of the drawing. And also you can just turn it on a side, and then it works like very good with details, because you know this little angle on the side of the brush, it works very good as a fine tip. And they are also very comfortable for blending the colors. And I have kind of variety of those flat brushes, like a bigger one, a smaller one, and a very small one. And I prefer them over the round brushes for gouache. And the synthetic material is very good, because it's kind of easy to ruin the brushes which are made of fur, like a squirrel or anything else, or sable, or how it's pronounced in English. I hope I said it correctly. They are kind of easy to ruin with gouache, because it's sticky and it dries. If you didn't manage to wash it immediately after you painted something, you can ruin a pretty expensive brush. So synthetic brushes are really good, because they are, even if you forget about them, you just wash them and they are fine and nothing happens to them. And also kind of, I'm not really sure if they are environment friendly, because this is questionable since it's synthetic materials, but they are durable for sure. If you work with them and if you take care of them, you can work with synthetic brushes for ages and you won't be in need of buying anything else. Because I really, really like the natural material brushes, even though I'm not really sure whether it's ethical to use them, maybe not, but I still don't know how to completely replace the natural brushes with synthetic materials, even though most of my working brushes are of mixed materials. They kind of is a mixture of natural fur and synthetic fur. And but still, I try to mostly use synthetic brushes for where I can. And the more I do this, the more I can see that in so many cases they're just as fine as the natural ones. So I kind of love it. Well, it's 18 minutes, guys. 18 minutes of me talking in English and still not wanting to run away screaming and just switch off the recorder and do this all from the scratch and write a script. And I'm not even started to feel stupid. I'm still not really sure that anybody is still listening, but if you do, what I'm doing right now in the painting, I'm working on the part of the body which is my nemesis. I have two nemesises when it comes to body parts. Those are feet and toes, and neck and collarbones, especially in this angle, because I always feel kind of, I really don't know what I'm doing when it comes to all those bones, which you can see in this place when the collarbone meets the shoulder. This is the hardest part for me to paint, because I always like mess up with proportions and with the perspective, especially when I don't have a very clear linear line art. When I don't have it, I always feel like I have no idea what I'm doing, and this is what happened to me as well. So I kind of, you know, I try to touch this area, which is so hard for me to do, make a few strokes, see that it doesn't look the way I want it to, and come back to paint and need some more details on the face, because the face is something that I am sort of feel much more comfortable and much more confident with, because faces is easier for me. I've been drawing them for years right now. And bodies, I've also been trying to paint them for quite a while, but not as much, and definitely not in this technique. I sort of miss the ability to press, to tap twice, like on iPad, just to simply correct what I did, or to use the liquify tool to easily correct my mistakes. And this is what I do, as I can see. It's not fun. Actually, it's kind of funny to watch the way I try to avoid the hardest places for me. Like, I just... When right now, in the retrospective, when I see how I was making my decisions while painting this artwork, I can see that I was being a chicken, and I started something which was pretty complicated and just immediately ran away to something else which was less complicated. If you guys also do this, let me know in comments what is the worst, the hardest and most complicated thing for you when you draw, because for me, I told you, it's collarbones and shoulders and toes and feet, and I wonder what is your nemesis when you draw. Let's discuss this, and how do you deal with it? Do you actually ever touch this? Because, you know, in many cases, I just avoid doing this. I had a painting, which you can see if you look in my Procreate time lapse, it's called Daniel, the original character. I will leave the link here, so you can just press here and go watch the video. That was painted from the female reference, but I turned it into a guy, and you can see there, right to the end, almost to the end of the video, that I was like messing with collarbone and shoulder because I wanted him to have a naked neck. And then I just understood that I am not going to deal with this anymore. This is too hard. Oh my god, this is so hard. And I simply just got him dressed, because that was much easier for me. And I even gave him our neck tie, which was pretty high and covering his neck so much that that wasn't almost a little piece of skin visible, because he was wearing kind of a period clothes, like maybe a Victorian male suit with, you know, with that high collar. And all of this only because I felt so angry at myself and so insecure about how I was completely unable to paint a decent neck in this angle. And even using reference, even looking at like at photos of men in almost identical angle, I still was doing something stupid and not anatomically correct. And I felt so angry that I decided to cover it all up with clothes. Just please keep in mind that when I say that it is stupid, I'm talking about myself. I'm not talking about anybody else, and everybody is totally fine the way they draw anything. It's just my own issues as an artist, because sometimes I just feel this very unpleasant feeling of being helpless to overcome some really complicated subjects, because my mind, it already knows how it should look, but my hands and my skill is not good enough to fulfill it completely. And when I draw, I see my mistakes, I just don't know how to fix them, and this is the worst thing ever. In fact, I really wonder what is going to happen when I'm going to listen to this audio file and probably realize that maybe this is doesn't make any sense, that maybe I should just delete it and or fix some of the mistakes I made while doing this. But I solemnly swear that I will try to fulfill this to the end and not do this, not edit it away completely. Maybe I will just edit a little bit, maybe I will record something else just to make it sound nice. But oh, it's almost 25 minutes, guys, and I'm still going on. Like, really, I am so amazed with myself. I would have never thought that I would be able to do this. This is one of those times when I feel that I am much stronger and much better with my English speaking skills than I ever thought I would be. And this is also a victory, not only about painting, because hey, I almost, look, I almost can cure that area. I don't know what I'm doing here. Why am I adding some oranges? Maybe it will look nicer eventually. It's so funny that right now when I'm watching this, I feel this like, what am I doing? I shouldn't have done this. Oh my god, you're just destroying something good you did before. But well, okay, now I can see why I was doing this. This kind of looks almost fine. By the way, in this video, if you watch it till the end, which I hope you will do, and you will see if I managed to do what I did, if I completed the challenge, in the end of this video, I'm also going to show you how I edit my traditional drawing in Procreate and add some digital touches to it. So we will see how I do this, because I do this quite often, in fact. And I don't really think this is something bad, even though I've met some ridiculous opinions online that traditional art is essentially better than digital art, and the digital art is kind of not a real art, which I think is stupid, because I think it is real and it is hard, and it requires a lot of skill and knowledge and time and effort to do good in digital art. And I don't really think that digitalizing my traditional artworks is ruining them or kind of cheating, because I simply use different materials. It's like, to me, there is no difference whether I use some ink over my gouache or some golden foil or anything like this, or I just add some strokes or some pretty effects in Procreate, because both of those things are simply tools which we artists use to achieve and to fulfill our creative goals. And I do this really quite often, and this is what I love Procreate for, that it has those tools which make the final drawing so organic that it's pretty difficult to tell what is made digitally and what is made traditionally, and they kind of blend in together very well. And this is what I love it for, because it gives me so much more opportunity. In fact, after I bought my iPad and I did this in the middle of December, that was my Christmas present to myself, and which I think was the best present ever and the best investment I ever did in my life. Since I bought myself an iPad, I started to spend my time on digital techniques like kind of a lot. It simply sucked me in. I mean, owning an iPad turned me into a digital artwork maniac. Honestly, this is true. Before that, I was mostly doing some watercoloring, and but right now, when I probably a little bit calmed down after being so very much into all the possibilities the iPad gave me, right now I'm curious about how I can combine those two tools, which I both love, because for me, traditional artwork is so warm and so welcoming and even relaxing. And probably this is, as I told you before, this is why I chose gouache for this experiment of mine. And digital art is kind of gives me confidence in another field, because I feel that I can add anything which is missing, and I can correct any mistakes I made before. And I like this combination, the warmth and spontaneous kind of, I don't know, there is a word for that, spontaneity. I don't know, do you guys know the word for this? Like when you do something spontaneously, which there is for the traditional art, and the amazing amount of techniques and tools which you can use in digital art. I try to combine them both, and so you will see how it works out. In the end, we are kind of close to this, because it's been 28, almost 29 minutes of me talking non-stop without a script. Yay! And I feel so much kind of open up and so more relaxed right now. I feel like I'm talking to a friend. I never thought I would be able to do this. This is probably, I probably already said that, but I'm just so amazed with that. And as you can see at the moment, at the painting, I wanted to add some geometry to my painting, and I didn't really know what I was doing, and I just played around with different colors because I love this creamy texture and I love messing up with strokes. Even though at some point I had this feeling that maybe I'm ruining my image because it just looks so elegant with just the shape of his head and that orange background, but I just wanted to add something. At this point I was also almost happy with what I did, but then I decided, hey, I should add some more strokes, and I also didn't know what I was doing completely, and there was also a moment when I felt like I was ruining it completely because some crazy textures and everything was so accurate and so elegant, and then all those crazy strokes and dots and textures, and I don't really know what came over me, but I just wanted to go loose, go crazy, and that's what I did. But in the end I really loved the way it kind of battled my eternal desire to be perfect, and that was the aim of the video and the experiment, and I guess that it sort of affected the way I painted it as well. I just wanted to try whatever comes to my mind, and I loved the way it came out to be so expressive. Somehow, probably if I didn't challenge myself with trying new stuff without really planning, and this very image was also not planned. It is a complete improv, like the same as my audio, like the image was a total improvisation, because that was the point, that was the whole point for me as a control freak, and it worked out. And right now when I see it, I see that my doubts, they are understandable. I can see why I doubted myself, but I was okay. I mean, right now when I look at what I was doing, I can understand what was kind of, what emotion made me do this. This desire to break out of something so stiff. Oh, and here you can see the way I adjusted everything in Procreate. So what I did, I just corrected a little bit the shapes, added some highlights, corrected the values so the colors would look brighter, and added textures. Oh, I love adding textures. So that's what I did. And come on, guys, we are done. I made it. Congratulations to me. I made it. And I'm so happy. Thank you for being here with me, for listening to me, talking about all of this without a script, and helping me to come out of my box of anxiety and self-doubt. So please, follow me, subscribe to my channel for next cool videos. See you soon.